Yeah, we are again, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm telling you this. For those who always are on a fire on ganja, ganja is my sacrament. So anytime Big Stone uses this herb, because I don't smoke weed, I don't smoke rubber, I don't mix up this. This is natural herb that permeates the brain for the brain to function in an order of respect. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the Nyabingi Village in Scotts Park, and I'm here with friends upon friends upon friends, expressing their love, their loyalty to the King, to God Almighty, His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I. How do you feel, my brother? What are your thoughts?
I'm feeling wonderful. I want to say, here's His Imperial High Majesty, and His 125th Earth Strong. I don't want to give thanks to all the brethren and sisters that made this a reality. The respect, honor, glorify our true King, our Divine Majesty, that give us this energy to keep this up, running, and being action. This is so wonderful. It is so great. We all can see it in this aspect. The true reality of restoring the Solomonic dynasty within the full-fledged line of His Imperialized Majesty, and keep His work up, and keep His doing going, and living up within a cultural activity, and making our views, ideas, be surrounded around the Solomonic family of Ethiopia. I want to take this moment to hail up the Solomonic family, all the prince and princess, and ask them to have courage and faith in the Nyabingi movements and the Rastafari fraternity, for we are coming on strong to see to it that His Majesty works is being established in Ethiopia, establishing the throne amongst the human family, and to keep our good works up. So I say to you, one love, brother, and keep the good work up, Big Stone, and I hope you will always be around with us.
Thank you.
To see this great work up and running. Blessed love.
Ladies and gentlemen, I had the opportunity to stand with the second son of Marcus Mosiah Garvey in 2012 when we celebrated the 125th Earth Strong of the Prophet. It was Marcus Garvey, ladies and gentlemen, that prophesied the Imperial Majesty forwarding on this earth. So ladies and gentlemen, of course, we have that was present on that day of August 17th. 2012, when Dr. Julius Garvey was with us. What are your thoughts now that you hear Maureen Gutsmore at the 125th anniversary of His Imperial Majesty? What goes through your mind after experiencing the 125th of the Honorable Marcus Garvey?
This is wonderful. This is historical. You know, to be here witnessing such an event. I'm young in this thing. I'm learning. I'm here to learn, look and see, and I'm feeling great, you know, and it is a pleasure to be here.
As you know, right, it was Dr. Julius Garvey who spoke and told us that his father had always wanted to see the mansions of Rastafari come together in one fold, respecting and praising one God. So if Marcus Garvey wants that, what are your thoughts on the faith of Rastafarians scattered all over the world, coming together under one umbrella?
I can only second that. We must come together, because only togetherness is strength. You know? There should never be a segregation. We are one people, and together we must come.
I noticed that this sister is standing right there. You want to say something, my sister? Come right here. Come stand up right between us. How long have you been following the faith of Rastafari?
Well, I say 20 years or more, you know. But I would say from the day I was born. I was born a Rasta.
I know you must have been through a whole lot of tribulation. What are your thoughts today, and what is your name?
So my name is Queen Bee, otherwise Beverly All.
Queen Bee, otherwise Beverly All.
Yeah. Well, as I heard you talking about Marcus Garvey, my thoughts go way back, because I'm a part of the Marcus Garvey People Political Party.
Okay, great.
So I know that this is time now. The door is open. Rastafari take this message of Rastafari's organization or whatever you want to call it, whether some people want to religionize it and some people want to make it a way of life. For me, it's a way of life. And take it right around the world and take it back to Jamaica. So we're saying if we can do that, we are powerful people. We can do more. So this is time to not only take Rastafari, but to take Marcus Garvey, our brother Marcus, who points us to the way out beside us, and let us move on. Marcus Garvey, speak about the winds within the winds, the whirlwinds. It's time for us now to start this chant and stirring that wind. We need to start stirring that wind, because it's the time now for the wind within the wind to start blowing.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, she almost brought tears to my eyes, because I know she speaks from her heart. I know she speaks passionately, ladies and gentlemen. The Honorable Marcus Garvey, His Imperial Majesty, God Almighty, means a lot to us. And that is why we're here today with Queen Bee at Scott's Park at the Nyabingi site, making and paying our respect. Anything else you want to say, Queen Bee? Because that was great. Who you want to shout out to?
Oh, I want to shout out to my mom.
Okay.
And my sister, Ida.
Yeah.
My mother, Pearl Blake.
Okay.
And all my Rasta friends and family, Lordersville, Yorktown, Kingstown. And in the Millennium Council. I'm a part of the Millennium Council.
No problem. And you know, ladies and gentlemen, she said her mother's Pearl Blake. My mom was Pearl, also. Pearline Sinclair. She's now deceased. She died in 1989. And but she lives right here in my heart. It was a pleasure.
You never get rid of your ancestors, or you're a part of your ancestors.
A continuation of
your
ancestors.
Yes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor for us to have this conversation. There's a whole lot more conversation coming. Stay tuned. Don't touch it all. Firestone Productions. We'll be right back.